Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free clip from my larger Microsoft Word training course. Check out the link in the description or go to bringyourownlaptop.com for more. Hi there, in this video we're going to look at making a form, okay, that can be filled out in Word and be emailed to us. Okay, so a couple of things that make this form cool before we go in and make it is that you can't click on the word name, so people can't go in and adjust things, okay, and wreck your lines and stuff. Okay, but they can fill in here where it says click and tap to enter text, so I can put in my name. Okay, email address, easy. Might as well put in my actual one if you want to reach out. There I am. Okay, course title, this is quite cool. It's a drop-down menu. Okay, so we get to make some drop-down menus. Date of birth, we've added our date picker. Okay, this little checkbox here, so you can turn it on and off. Comments is not very exciting. Okay, just add any old comments, you like anything. Okay, and if you hit the submit button here, it's going to stick it in an email and send it to us, kind of. Okay, so let's get off and start making our form in Microsoft Word. All right, so I'm gonna bring in some text, just plain old text for my form, okay? So file, I'm going to go to open, and on your example files, there's one in 06, okay, called Forms. I'm gonna copy that, I'm gonna close it down and bring it into this document. Okay, so what I don't wanna do, remember, is I don't want these underlines, because underlines do this when people type them in and they destroy our formatting and everything kind of jumps around. So what I need to do is I wanna put in just some interactive forms, and we need to get a little bit nerdy, and it's not that hard, but we need to turn on something called Developer. Now don't be scared, okay, we're gonna go to File. We're gonna go down to Options. We're gonna go down to Customize Ribbon. We're gonna turn on Developer. It's kind of like some hardcore Word stuff that they hide away for us nerds, okay? But it's not that hard, I promise. Developer, I'm gonna have my cursor flashing where I want my first bit of text, okay? And just in this little option, I want you to kind of limit yourself. All this other stuff is a bit more scary, but just the stuff in here. There's a rich text box I'm gonna put in, and the plain text box. I'm gonna put in this plain text box. Rich text box allows people to put in all sorts of stuff. Okay, images and hyperlinks and stuff. I just want to force them into a plain text. So I can click on that second one. You can see here that now, when somebody clicks on it, they're going to be able to type into it. Okay, so I'm going to type my name into it. Cool, huh? So it kind of looks the same, except I can restrict you this in a little bit, so nobody can adjust the word name. Okay, the other thing I can do is I can start formatting this. So I'm going to undo till my text is gone. Okay, so how do I want it to appear? At the moment, have it selected, you can go up to this one called Properties, and you can start playing around with, do I want a box around the outside, or do I just want none? That's what I like more. Okay, you can start styling this with different paragraph text. Okay, you can create your own style for these forms, it's up to you. I'm gonna click OK. It just means that that's gonna sit there nicely, and when I start typing, there's no box around the outside, and people can fill in their name. So I'm gonna do the same thing here. Okay, I'm gonna go rich text box, I'm gonna go to Properties, and I'm gonna turn off. There's no line around the outside. Now, course title. So the text boxes are pretty easy. The course title is going to be different. It's going to be a drop-down box where people can pick from the options that I give them. And it's this one here. They call it a combo box. So I can click on this one here called combo box. Okay, and there's only one item in there at the moment. So we're going to go to properties. And down the bottom here, these are my, this is my drop-down list. We're going to leave choose an item because that's going to be the first option. We're going to click add. And I'm going to call this one, say they want to do InDesign training. Okay, with us, or they want to do Excel training. Excel training. Okay, I'm going to go through and add a couple of options. Got lots of courses. Okay, so these are the options I want to be here. Weird thing is, if I put a none, the drop down box doesn't work. So leave it as bounding box and click OK. And what will happen is people will come in, they'll be able to choose an item, who's the drop down menu, pick InDesign from the options. Nice. So I'm going to leave that as item there. Okay, date of birth. Okay, we could just leave this as a text box, but we're going to use the date picker. Okay, and with selected, I can go up to properties and I can decide on how I want this displayed. I like it like this. Okay, so it's got the day and the name of the month there. Click OK. All right, and next thing I'm going to do, do you require a laptop? This is going to be a checkbox. This is going to be like a, would you tick it if you'd like this to happen? So you can see it there's a little checkbox. Okay, nice and easy one. Click on it, gives this. I'm gonna get rid of the border around the outside. I don't know, it's the designer in me. I don't like border around the outside. Okay, so people can uncheck that or check it as they need. Comments, we're just going to put in another text box here. Okay, because I'm Dan, I'm going to go through and fiddle with all that. Nice. Okay, so that's how to create a form. Now we've got the details in there, but we've still got this problem where people can go through and start messing with our formatting. I just want people to only be able to type in these, okay, without messing anything up. So what we're going to do is we're going to look at this one here that says restrict editing. Click on him. I'm going to edit restrictions. Click on this one here, and I'd like to say that this means they can't change anything. I want them to be able to change nothing but filling in the forms. Okay, and eventually, okay, you have to hit this one that says start enforcing protection. Okay, so click that. I could put a password in so that only people that have the password can undo this. Okay, I'm just gonna click OK and not put in a password. Passwords always end up being a problem for me. So I'm gonna leave that. What ends up happening is I can save this, send it to people, they can download it, and unless they go into developer and go to restricted editing and go to stop protection, they can turn it off then, but 99.9% of the population are not gonna know how to do this, and even if they do, who cares? Okay, so I'm going to stop protection now so I can do some editing. So that's what you can do, go back and start editing these bits, but with it on, okay, editing forms, start protection, click OK, and it means watch this. I can't click on these, I can't click on the names, all I can do is enter my text into here, and I've got myself a nice little form that I can fill in now. Email, Daniel. Course item, can pick on Excel, my date of birth, laptop, quick comments. Great. Okay, so now what do we do when we want people to send it to us? Now the easiest way is get them to save it and email it to you, okay, or print it off and post it in snail mail. Now that's not ideal. There is a way of getting it, adding a button to it so you can get it to automatically email to you. The only trouble with automatic buttons is that we need to enable something called macros. And what happens is if I send this Word doc out to lots of people, or it's downloadable from my website and it has macros enabled, what will happen is a lot of people will freak out because macros can contain malicious stuff, okay, and viruses. So what people tend to do is, especially for big companies, is they don't allow people to work on documents that have macros. And also, it's a bit of a freak out for people that are opening the files. It says, would you like to open macros? Macros this, would you like macros enabled? A lot of people just don't. Okay, so you might just have to write, please email this document too at the end, okay, unfortunately, or print this document off and print it and send it to us. Okay, so let's say we're gonna go the whole hog and do the button option. So to get our button in there, we need to, over here where it says restricted editing, let's stop restricting it for the moment. And you're gonna have to have your cursor kind of somewhere else where your button wants to go. And up here, there's this little drop down option, and we're gonna use this one here, rectangle, it's called command button. Give it a click. Okay, now double click it. And what needs to go in here is a bit of code. So I've given you a bit of code. I'm gonna go back into Word. Okay, and I'm gonna go to file, open. In your desktop, on your exercise files, there's one called forms, and there's one in there called send form button code. Okay, open it up, grab that, copy it, okay, and paste it into our Visual Basic. Okay, so this opens in the background, don't be scared by it, it's a little scary. Okay, and just paste that between these two lines here. The thing we might change as well is the name of the button. By default, where is it called? Caption, because it's called command button one. Let's just call this one submit. Cool, and I'm gonna close it down, and now I've got a submit button. Now, to make the button work, we need to enable our restrictions again. Okay, so I'm gonna click off down here. Where am I gonna click? And before it let me save, I need to switch off design mode. That comes on automatically. Okay, back to this mode. Okay, let's hit save. Yes, start enforcing. What I might do is I have to go and clear off. I've got lots of text that I had in there. Okay, so because I'm turning this back into a regular old form that doesn't have my details in it. Okay, so I'm gonna have to go and pick that first option because I messed about with it. Cool. All right, so we've got it all in there. We're gonna enable our protection, click OK. Now it's a form they can fill out, okay? And when they're ready, they hit submit. And what it'll do is it'll open up Outlook. Now, because I've been working on this document before, I've already enabled macros for mine working. What will happen for other people is when they open this document, there's going to be lots of warnings saying macros are being enabled. So, not an ideal solution, but probably the best one is to have a little thing that says please print or please attach and send to this email address here. All right, that is how to make a form in Microsoft Word. How'd you find that video? Was it good? Was it bad? If you liked it, go check out more of my courses on bringyourownlaptop.com.